artificial intelligence. It's mostly about computers interpreting numbers gathered from large data sets to answer business questions. All well and good, but what does that mean to you? Whether you're hot or cold on the subject, maybe it's time for us to inject a few examples. Flu epidemics. They come around every year, making thousands miserable and challenging care providers with daunting logistics problems. We fight flu using vaccinations and medicines, but we only have a finite amount. Where should we send them? We don't know. But if we could know where the flu would be worst, we could rush vaccinations there early and save lives. That was Google's premise when they studied whether they could predict the flu. They mined 5 years of web logs containing hundreds of billions of searches for terms such as runny nose and how cold is related to flu. It turned out that when those search terms popped up frequently in a specific region, or even part of a city, that reliably indicated a flu breakout. In fact, it was such a good indicator that Google's study predicted the flu up to 2 weeks sooner than the Center for Disease Control. Thus, Google helped the CDC prioritize their flu vaccine routing. Even better, this new epidemiology model could be extended to other contagious diseases, potentially saving even more lives. This case shows the extraordinary power of investigating massive data sets to derive insights. As a kid, I hated math class and I called it death by numbers. But I was wrong. With big data analytics, math is life by numbers. The term artificial intelligence was coined way back in 1956, and some of the earliest attempts at AI grew out of the code-breaking efforts of Alan Turing in World War II. Even with the limits of 1950s computing technology, some of those early machines learned how to play checkers. But AI as a science endured a dormant period, until exponential gains in computer processing and storage media began about 15 years ago. Now, AI is in your life every day. If you bought a book from Amazon or rented a movie from Netflix, you've seen their recommender engines. These recommender engines are actually AI, a form of machine learning that detects patterns in customer preferences. When you gather daily data on what millions of customers rent, you can see, for example, that viewers who like Mythbusters typically also like the White Rabbit Project. These are simple examples of the business value of analytics. Now that almost all business has an online aspect, analytics might mean more to your business revenue than your core business does. Maybe you sell the world's best doggy chew toy. Well, guess what? Customers will buy a worse chew toy from someone else unless your analytics can spot qualified customers, record their online order from any device, track your shipments to them, and trigger inventory reorders in time to fulfill demand. Thomas Davenport, in his book Competing on Analytics, says you can rate organizations based on their commitment to analytics. Analytically impaired companies gather no data or don't query their data. These lowest-ranked businesses barely exist today, except maybe as your kid's lemonade stand. Localized analytics are businesses that analyze some things, but in silos, not business-wide. As you travel up the pyramid, on top of the heap are companies that use analytics as a competitive advantage. That is exactly what Amazon did with their Also bots to gain an advantage in the book industry. You could buy the exact same book anywhere, but because Amazon used machine learning algorithms and collaborative filtering, today, 41% of all book sales go to Amazon. If today analytics drives business, who would you want to work for? The analytically impaired or the analytically advantaged? If you want to direct your career into a growth path, that's an issue you might want to analyze. In this episode, we've looked at how analyzing big data can drive businesses and how AI is present in your everyday life, whether you're getting a flu shot or relaxing at home with a movie. When you talk to a smart speaker like this one, all that is in here. It took an astounding amount of effort to teach these computers to converse naturally and act upon your request. That effort is already changing our way of living, yet simultaneously, AI is expanding as a new science that will be stronger and better in the near future. How will you and AI work together tomorrow? Join us next time for a look ahead at the AI Challenge.